Hey, long time no see, especially in front of the camera. But what brought me back is something, well, I've said before in the past, I know it's been a long time, that I used to like doing these a lot, whether I came up with the questions or someone else did, which in this case, someone else did. Anyway, Matropolis, Matt, he came up with this, five gaming questions for the community, as the title is, and one isn't actually specifically about games, but whatever, the rest are. Anyway, so, of course, nothing different here. As usual, down below in the description is a link to his channel, the original video, which if you want to do answers yourself, do it on his video, not mine, because he came up with them. And all that, also all five questions in order are also in the description in case you want to see that. Alright, so let's get this going here because we all know I have a tendency to go on too long and I don't want to do that this time. Anyway, so the first one is, and I've thought about this myself and talked about it around, so I got this under wrap what my answer is. What TV show would you like a modern game of? I've always said that personally because I like it a lot and I thought it would lend itself well to a game, a specific type of game, which I'll get to in a second. Burn Notice, which is also still one of the more recent shows I like, even though it's fairly old at this point from when it started. Anyway, it's like a cross between James Bond and MacGyver if you've never seen it or heard of it. Long story short, I always thought that because of how that show is, if you watched it, you know what I mean. You probably can see where I'm going with this. I always thought that it would lend itself well to an adventure game more than anything else because we have shitloads enough of first-person shooters and all this other crap. But I thought something like an adventure game would work well for it, given the MacGyver nature of it and all that. And even then, just I kind of would like a new adventure game, much less one based on something I like. It would be kind of cool. Sort of, I guess, maybe like a Grim Fandango style, and less than like Indiana Jones and Fate of Atlantis. I mean, they're both adventure games, but they work kind of different, if you know what I mean. That's what I'm thinking of here. I probably would actually go with the Fate of Atlantis type style. I don't know. Anyway, so that was basically always what I've thought of for top for this kind of thing. I've thought about it myself many times what I'd go with, because we don't really get many TV show games based on TV shows these days, for the most part. Much less for me, anyway, ones I like a lot. I just hope it would turn out good. That applies for any of this kind of stuff, obviously. Alright, so moving on here, the one that's not about games specifically. Number two, if you could have an. Let me try that again. If you could only have watched one cartoon from your childhood, what would it have been? I saw it when it was done its initial run, but I would go with probably the original Transformers, G1. Liked it a lot. My thinking here with this is it would have to be something that I wouldn't mind seeing again through its run again, much less multiple times. And for me, that's pretty much the top one I can think of, even though there's other cartoons I really liked a lot. I think overall that one, to me anyway, or just in general, given the animation, certain other things with it, and just the appeal, held up better than some other stuff, so I wouldn't mind doing that with it. That was my thinking. Also, I mean, I just got the, for example, I finally was able to get the original movie, the 1986 animated movie, again on tape, which I wanted specifically on tape, for you ask. Just going off of that alone, it's still as enjoyable as it was to me when I saw it long, long ago. So, hey, there's that. So, my thinking is the TV show would be much the same. That, and I've always liked robots a lot. I like vehicles. It's got that going for it, too. So, hey, there's that angle just as it was originally. So, I can't complain with that much at all. So there you go. That's the best one I can come up with. Again, while there's other cartoons I like a lot, I think that one probably has the best chance and would be the best candidate for me. I imagine many others would go with Transformers, though, given how popular it is. That's not why I went with it. I mean, others probably would go with G.I. Joe, which I understand that one too. I was far more into Transformers, appealed to me more. I like G.I. Joe too, don't get me wrong. Anyway, number three here, going back to the game questions. This one is always the hardest one for me with any time it comes up or however, variation it has on it, but fortunately he put the thing I was hoping for in there is either you are most like or can relate to. I have to do relate to. Even then, I feel like I'm fudging it a little, just to say that. Anyway, three is game character that you most relate to or most like you. I don't really think, given how games are and the way many characters are, there's many that are like us to that close extent. So I'm going to go with relate to, and even then, to be honest, as I've already said, I think I'm stretching it a little, but I've fought this since I started playing the game. It's also why he's one of my favorite characters. I actually like him more than the main character you play as. So for me, I'm going to go with, is for relate to, closest I can think of, I see enough of myself in him, in many ways, would be Ignis from Final Fantasy XV, which I still need to get as a standalone episode, which I'm most looking forward to, and take a guess why. I don't really know how to explain it much better than that. other than I see certain aspects of him with me. I see correlation there, so I can relate to in that way. Also, why I like him so much. That's the best I can give you. It's a pretty recent game, I know, but before 15 finally came out and changed his name and was 15 from Versus 13 and all that, who I would have said before that, I don't know if I could go with a game character. It might have to be someone from a book or a movie. I really don't know. It's not something I really thought about much, mainly because I just didn't see any kind of that kind of connection. Which you can say what you want about it, and not to get into this with how, you know, whether you what do you think about 15 or not, whether you like it or not, and even based on the main four characters. It is kind of, to me, it's kind of amusing that it's only taken that long until I do see a character that I can say, to that degree, I can relate to, or I see enough of me in them. I don't know. It's taken a while, apparently. It's the way things go. But it's still a good question. I just have a very hard time with it. I don't know. It's not one for me, really. All right, so number four here is, what game series do you collect merchandise for? I know I'm going to be boring with this, but some of you, if you remember, I know it's been a long time since I've been on here, or even those of you I talk on the Twitters, you probably already know the answer to this and the reasons why. I don't really do that, to be honest. I could go on a long time with this, and I'm actually doing this a second time because I didn't like how the first one turned out because I went on so long about this, but it just doesn't do it for me. The games cost enough themselves, the old ones and the current ones, and I don't have a lot of money to begin with, and I mainly am interested in want the games, and that's all I need. I love soundtracks, as many know, not just games, but that's always been like the top extra thing I like if I can get it, which even with games, for many of them, especially ones I like, they're a pain in the ass to get a hold of for the most part. Some games I really like that have soundtrack releases, specific soundtrack releases, official ones, only came out in Japan, so that does no good for me. Unless it's old games like on the Saturn, which 99% of them you could just play like on audio CD and even rip them, so there you go, they're their own audio soundtrack. Whoop-de-doo. That's easy. Sometimes it's like an art book for certain games where I don't have a lot of those either, or I have a few, like I have the Mega Drive Genesis Collected Works book, that's a special thing. I have a few others, but not a lot. I never really went into that because I have no desire to have anything like that besides the space it takes up and the cost, which a lot of it, that is the problem, the cost. Also, some of it just doesn't appeal to me. A lot of people have those statues or figures, I don't know which one you would call them sometimes, or one or the other, it all depends what they are. I've seen the astronomical prices they cost, I just can't do it. I mean, they look nice, really good detail, even for like a character or a game I really like a lot. Yeah, it probably might be cool, but I just don't have a use for it, or much less a place to display it, especially when I'm only going to be the one to look at it. And it just doesn't do anything for me, that's all. I may be boring in that way, but it just doesn't do it for me. Which, not to go on about this much longer, but as an example for you, I think to understand this better, even outside of games, I really don't do this, much for the same reasons. The only closest example I have for this would be the X-Files, which I have beyond just the whole run of the show and video and the two movies. I have a few other things, again, mostly books and two games, which is the same game, just different platforms. The FMV game, the watered down but still good PlayStation version, which I can't even use anymore, but I kept it because I like it. One, I like the X-Files a lot, my favorite TV show, so I want things for it, and also the computer version. But that's about as far as I go with anything else, even outside of games, which two of those are games, I know. It's just never been a thing for me. I like looking at what other people have. I like looking at some of the stuff and think it's cool. A lot of it then scares me off with how much it costs, so even if I wanted to go for it, I just don't. I can't justify it. It's just not my thing. That's all. Might be boring, but hey, it's the honest truth. I do think a lot of it looks cool, don't get me wrong. I am really kind of insulted by the prices on some of this stuff, and I just can't fathom why, other than they can. Some of the figures is amazing what they go for. I get it, the time and effort and the detail, but even then, it doesn't do anything. It's not like a Transformer. You can't turn it into a vehicle and back into a robot. It doesn't do anything. Yeah, whatever. That's why I was into those. That my whole action figure phase died long ago anyway. Alright, so fifth and final question. Sorry about going on about that. I'm trying to avoid that here. What is your go-to game? This is a little hard because it changes over time because you add new ones, which the main one I want to mention here is one like that, which is Forza Horizon 4, which before that was Forza Horizon 3. I've gone on before how things are for me with these open world or even not open world racing games where I could just go at them for shitloads of amount of time you'd be amazed with and just listen to my music playing them and I do whatever I want, make up my own goals, and I have a ton of time with it. I mean, it's like a Sunday drive of cars you can never afford, never even see, and no fuel cost. It's amazing. I love it. I do that in Forza Horizon 4 a lot. I did it last night. Why listen to podcasts or music? So that's one thing. But I know he's only asking for one, but just to make up for, you know, what I said in the other ones, I'll give you a few other examples. Some I've mentioned before. Yes, of course, OutRun is there, the original mainly. Although 2006 Coast to Coast is one there too, but I still usually go with the original one because it's just a special game to me. The Ultimate Doom is still a top one for me. Even if I'm not playing with mods, I can just play the game stock. I still use like a source port, but whatever. I still have a ton of fun with that. I can play it for a short amount of time or a long time, just like, you know, what I said about Forza Horizon 4. I get a lot from it no matter what I do. I think that's three or four now. I'll give you one more example for this, and because RPGs is another tough thing for me, I do have a few like this. Usually open world ones where I can do whatever the hell I want. While it's not my favorite in the series, Skyrim is kind of like that, just because all the crazy mods I can find, but a better example would be Fallout New Vegas, which is my favorite in the series. And I just can... It's one of those ones you can just get lost in it and do whatever the hell you want. Even if I just go in it to play Blackjack, which I've done that plenty of times. I love Blackjack, so I'll just play it in there, and I can also, you know, get the whole atmosphere of the world in there too at the same time. It does a lot for me, is all I mean. So I got some old games in there and a few more newer ones. I think it's a good example and balance and gives you a good idea for what it is for me with this kind of thing. But it's a good question, too. Anyway, so I've rambled enough about this and didn't really achieve my goal of cutting this down from the first attempt. But I think I did it better. Anyway, so that's it. Thanks for watching. Again, as I said, the links are in the description to his channel as well as his original video. And if you want to do answers, do it on his video because he made the questions. And I hope I didn't bore you and maybe you found some of this interesting. Maybe something I didn't mention before you know now. Whatever. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. And I will see you whenever the next time I do another thing is. Bye.